Everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Conde.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you at home for tuning in to Tattletales. Welcome. Nice to have you with us. Nice to have all of you, too. Thank you for that nice welcome. We have a nice surprise for you today, too. We have three terrific celebrity couples, and they're going to win you some money. Is that what you want? Let's do it then, shall we? On my left, winning money for the blue section, dressed in blue appropriately enough, from Emergency, Mr. Bobby Troop and his lovely wife, Julie London. There you both are.
We don't have the seal.
How's that for an opening line? No, do we have the, is our seal with us here today?
Yes, but we don't have him.
You don't have him today. Wait a minute. I think you've got a dog over there in the blue section. I heard a couple of barks. Okay, next to Bobby and Julie winning money for the banana section today, Mr. Army Archer and his wife, Selma.
I got the seal.
You got the seal today, Selma. Aren't you lucky?
The seal, yes.
Yes. You know our friend who comes here. We have a pet seal on Tattletales. You didn't know that, did you?
No.
Well, now you know. And it's nice to have you both with us. Good luck to you today. You're not playing any favorites with that shirt, are you, Arnie?
No, I'm right. I just noticed it has a little...
Not taking any chances.
Yeah, a little of last night's dinner, breakfast, and lunch.
Yes, right. You've got blue, red, and yellow in there. Next to Selma and Army, resident crazies with us, winning money for the red section, Mr. Orson Bean and his wife, Carolyn.
The best thing we can come up with for our section is a chicken.
Is a chicken? Have you got a chicken over there?
Is a chicken?
I hope you do.
I hope not. I don't like chickens.
Oh, all right. Here we go.
Mean, like stupid, this. Malevolent. If it weren't for Colonel Saunders, we'd be up to our... Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay. Here we go, gang.
Yes.
First person worth $150, and this is it. Ladies, can you turn your husband on anytime you want to, day or night?
Whoa.
Don't say anything. I only read them. I don't write them. You must remember that.
But you read them with such full expression.
Yes, ladies. Can you turn your husband on anytime you want to? Day or night. Think about it. We'll be back
for your answer. I'm losing this boy.
Goodbye, girls. Okay, Bobby, what's the answer with Julie?
You just turn me on.
Oh. I think you've been sticking your head in those fires too much, Bobby, on Emergency.
No, we've been together for 21 years, and honestly, I know people say this, and it's not really true, but she never ceases turning me on, anytime she wants.
Very sweet. I don't think anybody will agree with that. Don't think she'd have any trouble in that department, any, but what's the matter, Orson?
I was just going to say, me too, Bobby.
Okay, let's bring on Julie.
All right.
Julie. Are you there? There she is. Can you turn Bobby on anytime you want to, day or night?
Yep. That's
right. Seems kind of silly for me to say you're right. Of course you're right. You know that you're right. And you are right. And you have a share of the pot, too. Only, how about Selma? Did she turn you on anytime,
day or night? Crazy or something? You think anybody here is going to say no? You've got to be kidding.
Wouldn't it be? You're right. How could you really say that?
Well, I'm not going to be the fella.
You couldn't say that to go home with her.
Oh, sure. Selma turned
out. Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
Hey, night. Even leap year.
Even leap year. On the 29th of February. Let's bring her on.
Succinctly, yes.
Selma, can you turn Army on anytime you want, day or night?
But of course, darling. And sometimes when I don't want also.
Surprise, surprise. You have a share of the pot. Orson, what's Carolyn going to say?
Oh, yeah. We've been married almost 10 years, and I am in a continuous state of sexual arousal.
Chickens.
You really are an animal, Orson. Yeah.
Bestial. He was when I dated him.
Yeah. So the answer, therefore, is
yes.
Yes is the answer. Yes. Bring on that little darling.
Carolyn, can you turn Orson on anytime you want to, day or night?
Yeah, you want to see how easy it is to do?
And we'll come back in just a moment. It's been all the rest of it. Question number two coming up. It's for you, ladies. It's worth $150 as well. This is it. Ladies, yourself excluded. Who do you think is the sexiest girl your husband knows?
Oh,
don't say anything now, girls. That's not easy. Yourself excluded, who do you think is the sexiest girl your husband knows?
What are we going to say, honey?
Now, hear the wording of that. Who do you think is the sexiest girl your husband knows? Huh? See?
Not who he thinks.
No, that's not what it says. It's yourself excluded. Who do you think is the sexiest girl your husband knows?
Not who he thinks, who we think.
I'm not going to say that. I'm going to say what I said, and you go away and think about it now. Okay, Bobby. Who do you think?
I have to know the girl.
Well, I would say, yeah, I think you ought to know her, because it says, like, who is the sexiest girl your husband knows?
Like, I don't know Sophia Loren, but I would say that would be Julie's answer.
It says your husband knows. K-N-O-W-S means to know them, doesn't it, Pyro?
Yes, it does.
Means, producer knows.
I wish I did know Sophia Loren.
Will you stop going on about Sophia Loren here?
Katharine Hepburn is another one. I think she's a very sexy older woman.
Yes.
And I don't know her either.
Do you know anybody that's sexy, Bobby, besides Julie?
Yes. Isn't that terrible? I can't answer this question.
See, that's good. Julie would be thrilled with that.
Just let me think for a moment.
Okay. That towering fear. I thought I'd sing while we were waiting.
Could you go to somebody else? Will I think for a minute?
Well, sure.
Would you?
Sure, we'll go to Army. Army, it's a tough question for you, too.
Would you mind going to somebody else?
You're next. Armin, do you want to take a stab at this?
As I understand the question.
Yes.
It's who does Selma think is the sexiest person that I
know? Did you know? Uh-huh. Because I have asked them. Who do you
think? Well, you know, that's a very tough question because in my line of work, just a minute.
Perhaps we should explain that Armin writes a column every day for the Daily Variety here in Hollywood. And all over.
And knowing so many, you know, beautiful, sexy women would really, but I would think that Selma, if she made a choice, she would probably say Elizabeth Taylor.
Really? That she thinks that she's the sexiest girl that you know?
Yeah, I think that's what she would say.
Do you think that Elizabeth Taylor's the sexiest girl you know?
That isn't what you asked.
Do you ever think about going into politics, aren't you? I think you have a great future. You're going to say, she will say
Elizabeth Taylor.
Elizabeth Taylor. Let's bring Selma on and find out. Selma, who do you think is the sexiest girl your husband knows?
Well, a full-grown lady. Elizabeth Taylor.
That's...
And he knows her a little bit too well.
She said, I know her a little too well, too.
Yes. That's amazing that you would pick her out of all the actresses and people that the Army comes in contact with.
Well, she's such a minor star, I can understand.
Yes, that's true. Okay.
And ugly, and what has she got?
That's true. Okay. You have a share of the pot. That's what you got at the point. At this point. Or do you want to, listen, Bob, you want to take a crack? You want to wait a little while?
I'll wait a little.
We'll move on to Orson. Moving right along to Orson. What's Carolyn going to say? Selma. Sorry, old man. Margot Sappington. Margot Sappington is the sexiest girl that you know, as far as Carolyn is concerned.
That's the only one that comes to mind.
Is there a person named Margot
Sappington? Of course, Margot Sappington was in Old Calcutta.
Yes.
Did a beautiful dance in it.
Is she sexy?
I met her once.
Yeah. Do you know her?
I know her, not in the biblical sense at all. I said, how are you, Margo?
Do you have carnal knowledge?
Yes, okay. So you're going to say, Carolyn will say Margo Sappington.
That's what I'm saying. It ain't much of an answer. It's the best thing I can come up with.
Let's bring her on. I think Bobby's going to take that one, too. Let's bring on Carolyn. Carolyn, who do you think is the sexiest girl your husband knows?
Wow, you know, you can really lose friends over a question like this. I really don't know. I'm going to just take a guess and say Patsy.
Patsy.
Okay, that's not what Orson said.
Orson said.
Tell Carolyn who you said. And I'm dying to know who Patsy is, because I know.
Patsy, yeah.
I think of Patsy. Now he thinks so.
But I'm curious. What did you say?
I said Margot Shappington.
Ah. She's good, too.
You both have the same reaction. That's what she had.
Oh, Patsy. Yeah.
Sorry about that, gang, but you can sit there and think about that.
I want to meet them both. That's all I know.
Yeah, let's get Margot and Patsy together.
Oh, yeah, I remember the
Who's
thing
Patsy,
you had
by
for
the...
her for
who
all
is Patsy?
Years.
Patsy?
Never mind who Patsy is.
Go to the next question. He didn't even answer.
No, Bobby needs more time to think about it anyway. Who's Patsy?
Patsy. Golden Retriever. That's who Patsy is.
Never mind.
Patsy is a very interesting. She's got the fires of life. Running bright. Patsy.
You told me that you thought that she was really a turner.
Yeah, Patsy.
Yeah, Patsy.
I forgot about Patsy.
He's there now. You're reminding him. And, okay.
How quickly they forget.
Yes. Okay, Bobby, are you finally ready, sir?
I'm going to say Sophia
Loren.
I didn't say Patsy.
Patsy.
Yeah. You're hoping that she's going to see this and maybe buy it, aren't you?
Maybe.
Sophia Loren. Okay, you're going to say Sophia Loren. Let's bring on Julie. Julie, who do you think is the sexiest woman that Bobby knows?
Wow. That's really tough. I don't want to slight any of my friends.
Yes.
Oh, goodness. I really can't think whether it's, somebody... from afar, or somebody within the circle, I would say Sophia Loren.
That's right. She doesn't compare to Patsy. I can't believe it.
Well, we do have a couple of things in common.
Julie, you have no idea what we've been through out here trying to get an answer out of him. And he we skipped him. We went to Army, then we went to Orson. He just couldn't come up with anybody. And you say, oh, I don't know, how about Sophia Loren?
No, I know him better than he knows himself. Right?
I can't believe that. Well, you're absolutely right, and I hope your wish comes true, Bobby. Selma and Army split that pot at halftime, and we'll trade places, gang, if you will, send it in here. We'll break away. We'll come back if I can pull myself together to the rest of Tattletales. Come back. Okay, we are back. We've just changed places after halftime. I have the ladies with me. The fellas are in the back. We have 2/3 of a tie. Orson, you got to catch up, okay? Here we go, Patsy. Never mind. We're moving on. This question is worth $150 as well. Surprise, fellas! Your wife's pregnant. And it's going to be a girl. What name are you going to pick for the little darling? Okay?
No,
surprise! Surprise, surprise, your wife's pregnant and it's going to be a girl. What name are you going to pick for the little darling that's coming? Think about it, fellas. We'll come back and find out. Carolyn, we're going to start with you. What's Orson going to say to that? Is there a name left?
Is there a name left? That's funny. Gee, I'm trying to think of one of the names that
you considered.
Considered and didn't use. I don't know. I like Daisy.
I like that too.
Yeah. Well, maybe you and I should have a little girl.
Okay.
Was never crazy about the surprise, Orson. There's been a change in the plan.
Yes, surprise, Orson. It's Carolyn and me.
Okay, so, and Daisy makes three.
Yes.
So, I don't know. Ask him what he says. What do I know about these things?
You're going to say Daisy?
I guess. I can't think of anything better
to
say. Okay,
that's cute. I like that. Let's bring on Orson. Orson, what's the name of the baby girl?
Daisy?
Yes. I don't believe what's happening. I didn't believe it. You're right.
That's right.
I was going to say Petunia.
Yeah.
No, Petunia.
I love all sorts of those flower names. I love Zinnia.
Zinnia.
We talked about all different kinds of flower names, but Daisy is, you know, more common. But
had you talked about Daisy before?
We have, when we had Zeke, Attila the baby. We decided, you know, if Attila the baby had been a girl, he might have been Daisy. And now his name is Attila, is it?
Daisy Bean. Oh, I love that.
I wanted to call him Attila because I figured anyone that wanted to be born that badly.
Talk about surprises.
No, Daisy Bean is a terrific name. It's better than Navy or something like that. Julie.
Patsy, says. Okay. About Margo.
What's the name of the baby going to be, Julie?
Well, we went through a lot of good names already. I think I always liked the name Casey.
Casey.
Yeah.
And you don't have a Casey.
No, I have a Stacy, but I don't have a Casey.
Okay, that could drive a household crazy, you know.
Right.
Stacy, not you, Casey, Stacy.
Yeah, well, I always call them by the wrong names anyway. So
yeah, same thing. Okay, so you'll say Casey.
Yeah.
Let's bring on the fella. Bobby, what's the name of your new little girl going to be?
I have the vaguest idea. We have five girls between us, Cindy, Ronnie, Stacy, Lisa, and Kelly.
Yes.
Kelly was always our very favorite girl's name. So I just have to make a guess because I'm really couldn't think of it.
Well, you did pretty well with the last guess you made. Oh, never mind.
No, I really couldn't guess. Patricia.
Wrong.
What did Julie say?
Tell him what you said.
Casey, you dummy.
That's right.
We talked about that once.
I know we have.
You remember that now?
Had a close call, eh?
Remember now.
Okay, sorry about that, Bobby.
Okay.
You dummy. Okay. Selma, what's Harvey going to say?
Same question. Left field, okay?
That's a silly name for a girl. Left field Archer? That doesn't sound right. How about Apple? No, never mind.
I'm torn between Tabitha and Samantha. What do you think?
Tabitha and Samantha.
Okay, Samantha.
That sounds like it's going to turn out to be a cat.
What?
Sounds like you're going to have a cat.
That's what we're going to have, Bubsy. There's not going to be no baby, no.
Samantha. Okay, you're going to say what?
I forgot. Samantha.
Samantha, okay.
What's her name?
Army. Oh, I'm going to pieces out here. Army, what's the name of your little girl going to be?
Thanks a lot. I needed that. I'm sure she has explained to you in great detail.
No, I haven't. Shh.
Oh, I think there's a story lurking there.
Whoa.
Tell us about it, Army.
Never having discussed the problem.
Yes.
I have to come up with a name out of the blue, to be honest with you.
Yes, right.
So, I really would have to... you're all looking in at the very first time that I have thought of... Thank you. Of a name for a daughter that we would have. And this being created out of the blue this very second.
So, Mercy. So television first?
If television first, all right. How did the name Amy Archer fit?
Amy Archer is a really good name.
Not the name, however, it is.
But Selma,
but they're so rude, they applaud when we lose.
Selma suggested Samantha or Tabitha.
Samantha
or Tabitha.
As you can see, this was a first for television.
Yes, we can see.
And a last.
I'm sorry, Carolyn Orson, congratulations. You get the whole pot.
Hey! And then thank you, Bella.
Listen,
first,
with our double question, added in special field. Just a second. Be right back. Double question coming up. This one worth $300, and if you're ready, fellas, this is it. Good, tight game here, too. Men, who is more easily discouraged, you or your wife? Don't say anything. Who is more easily discouraged, you or your wife? Go away and listen to the music. Think about it. We'll come back for your answers in just a second. Julie, between you and Bobby, who's more easily discouraged?
Oh, boy. Both of us are terribly easily discouraged. Of the two of us, I would say probably he is.
He is. Bobby, let's bring him on and find out. Bobby? Between you and Julie.
We're both easily discouraged, but I think I'm more easily discouraged.
That's exactly what you said. Word for word. right on the button. Boy, you can't make a better match than that. You're absolutely right, sir. So don't be discouraged. Some, between you and Army, who's more easily discouraged?
Well, we all tonight getting discouraged at the wrong times. Generally speaking, I am more easily discouraged.
You are more easily discouraged?
Yes.
Okay, let's bring him on. Army, between you and Selma, who's more easily discouraged?
I must admit, I am.
You don't have to admit it.
I really almost said it.
Selma said she must admit that she was. I'm sorry, but don't be discouraged, Army. There'll be another day. Carolyn, how about Orson, between you and Orson?
Orson is.
Is he?
Yeah. He does not have a lot of patience.
Right. If it doesn't go his way, he'll rats.
At least
that. Okay, let's bring him on. Orson, between you and Carolyn, who is more easily discouraged?
Oh, I give up. I just can't think of an answer. Oh, I am.
I guess it's you. You're right. That means Carolyn and Orson, Julie and Bobby, split the pot. Split the $300. Very nice. Respectable total on the board. Hey, time is up. That's it. The red section wins it today. 15-1. We'll come back in a moment and find out how much they won after these questions for you. Please come back.
This is Gene Wood speaking for Tattletales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.